Okay, 1988's Bloodsport, certified classic. It's got all the ingredients of a great 1980s martial arts movie. It's got a training montage, it's got a tournament arc, it's got awesome fight choreography, it's got Jean-Claude Van Damme, and yes, a banging 80s soundtrack. Which, obviously, I can't play for you because of copyright concerns. But trust me, it's good. So if you've never seen the movie, Bloodsport follows a US Army captain named Frank Dux, who goes AWOL to participate in a super secret, super deadly underground martial arts tournament called the Kumite. The Kumite happens in this anarchic, lawless area of Hong Kong called the Kowloon Walled City, which, by the way, actually existed in real life, and all the best fighters in the world are invited. Think of it like Mortal Kombat, but without the fireballs and all the soul sucking.
Fatality.
Dux has to battle his way through the tournament and face a succession of ever deadlier warriors who utilize different disciplines to beat him. And it's all to restore honor to the Tanaka clan, a Japanese family with a martial tradition that he was basically adopted into. But the best part about Bloodsport is that it all actually happened. I mean, Frank Dux going AWOL from the army, the Kumite, it's all real. I mean, it has to be, right? They literally say at the end of the movie that it's based on a true story. Well, here's the thing. Frank Dux is a real person, but he may have made the entire story up. Now, if you've actually seen Bloodsport, that might not be the most shocking thing in the world to hear. I mean, even those of us who really want to believe, there are secret underground tournaments being held in the dark corners of the world where deadly men roundhouse kick each other into oblivion. Well, this movie gets a little far-fetched. Your first clue might be the mathematically improbable stats they decided to tack on to the end of the movie. But this story goes way deeper than some post-credit exaggeration. In fact, there are a number of articles and videos already out there that you can go watch and read about how Dux allegedly made the whole Bloodsport thing up. But the root of most of those seems to be a 1988 article in the LA Times by a guy called John Johnson. According to Johnson, the real Frank Dux did in fact operate a martial arts school in California. But as far as going AWOL from the army, traveling to Hong Kong to compete in a deadly martial arts tournament, well, his military records apparently show he never left San Francisco. But there's a lot more to it than that. For example, the trophy that Dux claims he won at the Kumite? Well, Johnson's article says that it was casually purchased by Dux in the San Fernando Valley. And when you think about it, what kind of secret underground fighting tournament gives trophies away? That doesn't even make sense. According to the article, Dux also won a sword at the Kumite, but he doesn't have it anymore because he sold it trying to buy the freedom of enslaved Filipino orphans. I'm gonna let that sink in a minute while I read you some quotes from the LA Times article of Dux apparently trying to explain that. Quote, "I sold my sword. I have no regrets for it. It went for a good cause. It went to buy kids out of slavery who were on pirate ships. The ships were crowded and uncomfortable. I'm talking what they call a normal bunk. They have four or five kids squeezed into that thing. They live out in the open elements. They die. And the Philippine government just turns a blind eye." So Dux said he and some friends decided to help out. He said he gave the pirates money from the sale of the sword, but the pirates reneged at the last moment. "We took up arms and fought the boat pirates, and we got these kids free. Many of them are now in the United States. I'm in touch with some of them, and they love me to death. And I'll tell you, I've got one kid who's about 15 years old. All I have to do is look cross-eyed at one guy, and he'll kill for me." End quote. Now, according to Dux, the real Kumite happened not in Hong Kong, but in the Bahamas. But Johnson's article says that Bahamian officials have no record of an event like that ever happening. Which is also really weird because, like, why would they? It's a secret underground fighting tournament. But if it was so secret, why did this dude make a movie about it? I don't know. Anyways, Johnson's article also includes quotes from apparently legitimate martial arts masters who claim that Dux is little more than a fraudster, and that he not only made up the whole Bloodsport thing, he's made up a ton of other shit too. They're even quoted as saying that Dux made up fake newspaper clippings and even fake military medals to prove some of his more outlandish exploits. Now, the whole story about the Kumite was originally told and written in Black Belt magazine. And from what I've heard, that's a publication that did have a reputation for sensationalism and exploitative content back in the 70s and 80s, when this article would have been published. I mean, we're talking about a publication that regularly puts Steven Seagal with a samurai sword on their cover. I'll let you take from that what you will. In fact, it looks like the widespread debunking of the Bloodsport story as probably fake has not stopped Dux one bit. Just go to his official website, which by the way is right out of 2003, and you'll find some absolute gems. And while you're there, why not buy a t-shirt with a completely unironic image of a giant snarling wolf on it that says, "Eat your brain for breakfast, Dux." Go to the official Dux Rue Facebook page and it gets even better. There are just so many photos of this man in a gi while wearing dark sunglasses. And I mean, who would not want this handsome calendar hanging in their home? But in all seriousness, is there any credible defense for Frank Dux's claims as they relate to Bloodsport that weren't written by Frank Dux? Well, there is something called the World Kumite Organization out there. Frank Dux was in the military, and he did and still does teach martial arts. And all of that sounds totally reasonable. But then you see stuff like this. This is the cover to Frank Dux's memoir, The Secret Man. Now, I have not read this thing, obviously, but please let me just read you the cover and you tell me if this sounds credible. He was the CIA's finest covert operative, the subject of the martial arts film Bloodsport, a bridge to international organized crime, a legend on both sides of the Iron Curtain. His true identity was concealed from the people he served. He was the Secret Man, an American warrior's uncensored story. And apparently, after this book came out, a number of high-ranking CIA officials were quoted as saying they never heard of Dux, and that his claims in the book were, quote, sheer fantasy, or virtually a complete fabrication. Ouch. Now, like I said, I haven't had the pleasure of reading this literary work of art, but someone else on Amazon did, and they left a review so the rest of us don't have to. Fails as fact and as fiction. The number of factual errors in this alleged autobiography would stun James Frey and Stephen Glass. General John Singlub directed the Phoenix Project? No. Bill Casey was short? No. A Makarov pistol is incredibly heavy? Hell no. Even if we put these objections aside, the book is crap. It reads like Tom Clancy fanfic, complete with cheesy dialogue, poorly motivated plot developments, and tales of derring do. Dux's actual military records are public, and they don't support even a little of his story. As for that 300-man Kumite, where are all those guys he beat? And where were their trainers, cutmen, cornermen, etc.? What secluded island would not make note of such a giant influx of people, yet be small enough that the secret would be kept? Sorry, Frank, but it's no dice. You've committed the worst error a self-aggrandizing BS artist can make. You're boring. That is the kind of book review that is more damning than any YouTube video I could make, or any article that John Johnson could research and write. But you know what? Even if Bloodsport wasn't based on a true story, it is still an awesome movie. All the folks at Canon Films had to do was resist the temptation to tack on that based on a true storyline at the end of the movie. If they had just cut that one single sentence, then Bloodsport would have gone down in history as a great martial arts movie free of controversy. If you like this video, you should totally check out my short, sad history of X-Arm, the world's dumbest combat sport.